Manjaro Linux. I think it's the best distribution around right now. I think it's very friendly to newcomers and to people with experience. And I think if you want to dip your toe into Linux, it's a great place to start. I'm going to show you a little bit about Manjaro, and I'm going to show you a quick way to get this installed on a virtual machine on your computer. So let's take a look. All right, this is Manjaro's website. You have the option to try Manjaro, and you can do a lot of research here. They have different versions based on the different desktop environments you want. XFCE is very common, KDE Plasma. A lot of people are loving that these days. GNOME, or GNOME, however you want to say it. I'm not a fan, but some people love it. Architect, I don't even know that one. It looks a little more technical. But those are just the official versions. They also support community versions. And if I were going to install one, I would choose this guy. The Cinnamon 18.1.3 right now is the current version out. If I'm going to install this on a computer, or if I want to spend some real time with a virtual machine to get one installed, I would download the Cinnamon version. I would go through the installer, and I would start playing with it. The good thing about the installer is that once you flash it to a USB drive, you can boot from that drive into a live environment. So you can actually boot into the OS and install stuff and play with it. Your changes won't stick because it's not a true OS, but it gives you the ability to see exactly how things work before you make a big commitment to install. So if you want to take a deeper plunge, go this way. But if you want to just have something to play with quickly, we will go to this great website called osboxes.org. This has pre-built virtual machines that require no installs that you can install using the Virtualbox software and be good to go. So in case you don't know, VirtualBox is a piece of software made by Oracle. You can get it for free at virtualbox.org. Just go to this website, download, install. You're ready to go on Windows. If you're in Linux, you can use your package installer. You can do something like a Pacman minus S VirtualBox. It'll probably find it. I'm guessing most of you are starting on Windows and you're just dipping your foot into Linux. So go to the website, download the file, install VirtualBox. Then go to osboxes.org. Now what we're going to be looking for is VM images, VirtualBox images, right there. And they have a ton. You can download all of these different operating systems pre-built into a computer that you don't have to set up. We're looking for Manjaro. They're in alphabetical order, so here's Manjaro. Click on that guy. Click to download the VDI image. It takes you to a page, gives you the option to donate, and tells you, you know, an overview about Manjaro. This is worth reading. It's got some interesting information. While we're here, let's talk a little bit about what makes Manjaro so great. Manjaro is a derivative of Arch Linux. Arch Linux is the base of it, and Arch is wonderful. It's just also very manual and very overwhelming for a new user, very complicated for someone that knows what they're doing. You boot into Manjaro's installer, it just gives you a prompt, and you've just got to struggle through getting every little piece installed. Manjaro takes care of all of that for you. Manjaro uses a regular installer, like most other distributions, and includes a package of really useful software, so you don't have to be downloading every little thing separately. You just have it all there ready to go. And then you can add what you want to it. So I highly, highly recommend Manjaro. It stays very up to date. There are different versions. There's stable release, there's experimental release, stuff like that. You can go back onto Manjaro's website and kind of explore what all that means. But the bottom line is that Arch gets updated constantly. Because that, some of the updates aren't so stable, Arch gets broken pretty regularly. If you download the stable release of Manjaro, it will still stay very up to date, but it will wait a week or two after an update rolls out before it comes into your operating system just to ensure that it's stable. So, Manjaro is easier to use than Arch, pre-configured, quicker to get into, safer to use than Arch, and has all the benefits. And the big, big benefit of Arch is that it has its own repository for software where you can download all the regular stuff. And it also has a user-managed repository where pretty much anything that you can imagine that works on Linux, you find in the AUR, Arch User Repository. And Manjaro has that built in right out of the box. So you can find what you're looking for. You can install it. Simple to use. So let's put it on a virtual box and play with it a little bit. So we would go here. We would scroll on down. We're just going to use the current version, this virtual box, and we will click download. All right. I already have it downloaded. Here it is in my downloads folder. It is called m18.1.0-vb.7z. It's a 7-zip compressed folder. So you might need to do a Google search to extract a 7-zip file if you've never done that before. But as long as you have a way to extract it, something like WinRAR would work, or that's all you need. So we're going to click to extract. I'm going to extract it into my downloads folder. Here it goes. By the way, this operating system that I'm in right now is Arch Linux with the Cinnamon desktop. I've made some modifications to it, but this is going to be very similar to what we're dealing with once we get Manjaro installed. So it's taking a second to extract. Let's just let that happen. All right, and we're done. I was getting a little bit worried because that took a bit longer than it usually does, but we're in business. Okay, so it's extracted the 64-bit folder into my downloads folder. See right here. You double-click there, and there's a VDI image. That's all we need, basically. We know where this is. It's in home, mark, download, 64-bit, VDI. It's important that it's extracted, but once you've got it extracted, you just open up VirtualBox, and this will look the same whichever operating system you're using. We're going to go to Tools. We're going to go to New. We're going to name it whatever you want to. I'm going to say Manjaro OS box. Now notice that it defaulted to Mandriva because it uses the first three characters that you type in to try to guess what kind of operating system it is. But this is Arch based, so we're going to tell it it's a 64-bit Arch Linux. We're going to go next. I'm going to give it a little more RAM than that. And so let's give it 4 gigabytes. And here's the big thing, hard disk. Use an existing virtual hard disk file and click on this to browse to find it. We're going to add. We're in downloads, 64-bit, and there's the file we downloaded. So there it is. We're using this drive. Notice that the virtual size is 500 gigabytes. The actual size is 7.6 gigabytes. That's just one of the quirks to VirtualBox is that it believes it has all this memory and it will expand up to that point. It just won't take up a full 500 gigabytes of empty space on your computer. So it's really useful. Okay, here we are. we're going to choose this, we're going to create, and there we go, Manjaro OS box. We're going to go to settings, and we're just going to kind of look and make sure everything looks okay. I'm going to enable shared clipboard and drag and drop. That all looks fine. That all looks fine. I'm not worried about that. I'll enable 3D acceleration. And I'll give it a whole bunch of video memory. And that all looks good. Nothing wrong here. Most of the stuff you can just leave as defaults. I do recommend enabling 3D acceleration. And okay. And we're good to go. So now, all we've got to do is start it. Click that start button. And we got nothing. So we're going to use this as a learning experience. We're going to shut that down. It actually was running something. I'm going to go into settings. And I believe what I told you was wrong. We are going to disable 3D acceleration. We use VBox VGA 2. And we'll go OK. And start and see if we have better luck this time. All right, now we're in business. But look at this. It brought us to a logon screen. What do we do now? Well, let's go back to the osboxes.org website. All right, here's where we downloaded it, right? And we downloaded this one. Always know where it came from so you can get back here if you need to, because info right there is very important. That tells you what your username is, what your password is, what your root account password is. All that is stuff you need to know. So our password is osboxes.org. I'm going to copy that. I am going to... we're not able to paste it yet because VirtualBox tools aren't enabled, but I'm typing osboxes.org and I'm logging in. And here we are. We are now connected to a wired network. We have a full desktop and the welcome screen. And from here, you can just... I'm going to turn that off because I don't want to see it every time. You can just start playing. This uses the XFCE desktop, which I don't like quite as much as Cinnamon, but this particular modification of it looks pretty good. We got a solid start menu. We got an easy way to get to the terminal. Got a good looking terminal. We got the package manager right there. 395 available updates. You see that popped up there too. So that is a thing about these pre-built things, these pre-built images. They're going to be a little bit out of date. So the first thing you want to do is apply all these updates. And that could take a while. It will ask for your root password, which we know is osboxes.org. You can also create your own user so you don't have to use theirs. That's all stuff you can Google how to do, or we may have lessons in the future. Just kind of click through to apply all that. And it's going to take its sweet time to get all this done. There we can kind of follow the text of what it's doing. But that's it. Once those updates are complete, you are good to go. You can reboot, you can save, you can install stuff. It uses the POMAC package manager, which is really cool. This is this thing. I can look at categories of software. I can look at games. It's not going to show anything because it's busy doing all this other stuff. See, about 8 minutes remaining. That's probably about accurate. We're not going to wait for that to get done. But I just wanted to show you how to get this thing up and running. You could also use right control and F key to make it full screen. And then, yeah, you're just in your virtual computer and you can ignore your regular computer. The education math, it comes, it's got GIMP already pre-installed. It's got LibreOffice already pre-installed. It's got Steam pre-installed. That's pretty handy. And all these applications, a lot of this stuff was stuff that I just kind of stumbled upon needing an Arch and had to find and install myself. It has them there already, which is wonderful. It has the Yay package manager pre-installed, so you can install stuff from the AUR, that user repository I was talking about earlier. This is just a very great way to get started in Manjaro Linux in particular. And then, if you determine you like it, you can go to Manjaro's site, download an actual install image, and then, yeah, I'd recommend installing one fresh once you have a little bit of experience with it. And if you have an extra hard drive, install it on that extra hard drive, create yourself a dual boot system, and then you've got all of your resources available within Linux. And that is fun, let me tell you. So I hope that helps. I hope that makes a case for why you might want to try Manjaro and how to do it pretty quick and pretty easy. And yeah, let me know what you think. Thanks. Bye.